target Baghdad, allies launch 500 cruise missiles in a day.
Since 2003, 130 members of the news media have been killed in Iraq. Most of them were Iraqis.
He once said to me, "If a drop of your blood spills, it is my blood spilling." That's the kind of guy you want watching your back, especially in Iraq. Would you give your life for another person? A colleague or a friend? Do you need to think about it? Because by then, it's probably too late. F-A-K-H-E-R. Fakher. Fakher Haider. That was his name. He didn't hesitate, and so I am here, breathing, still able to work as a photojournalist, and maybe one day return to Iraq. Fakher was what we journalists call a fixer, someone who helps us navigate in difficult places. Foreign journalists hire individuals like him to help us do any number of things. Guide, interpreter, security consultant, lifeline, research assistant, friend. Fakher was all these things, but perhaps most of all, he was brave. I met Fakher while working for the New York Times. A Shiite Muslim from southern Iraq, Fakher was managing a fertilizer factory when the war started. He said he found his life's calling when foreign journalists poured into Iraq needing local fixers. He believed that journalism was the best way to help his country, to expose wrongs, and hopefully build a better Iraq. We were in southern Iraq, in Basra, when he helped me gain access to a set of brothels that had recently come under attack by religious fanatics. The fanatics had thrown grenades into the brothels, injuring some of the people. In the back of a brothel, a tattooed man glared at me, trying to figure out what I was doing. One woman showed me her injuries, pulling up her nightgown to reveal small red pockmarks where shrapnel had lodged in her leg. I had only taken a few photographs when gunfire erupted outside. The fanatics had attacked again, and we were caught in the middle. Fakher and I took cover in a doorway, pressing ourselves tightly against the rough wooden boards. As I looked up, a man was turning a corner. His eyes enraged, he lifted his AK-47 and pointed it directly at me. I froze. Fakher stepped in front of me. He did not hesitate. He did not think. He placed his body between me and the barrel of the gun. He raised his hands and yelled to the man that we were journalists to convince him that we were not his target. There was a flash of recognition in the man's eyes. He nodded, turned slightly, and began firing down the alleyway in another direction. Fakher watched my back for the rest of the time, as prostitutes were dragged out of brothels and beaten. I photographed one woman as she was being led away. I wasn't sure if the men were there to protect her, or something else. I photographed the series, their hands clutching tightly to her wrists, and the fear in her eyes. Fakher guided and interpreted for me. And then, he leaned close and said it was time to leave. Reinforcements were arriving. Things were going to get worse. In the months and years after that day, Fakher continued working as a journalist, shining a light in dark places. Eventually, he was targeted. His body was found, hands bound, hooded, tortured, and dumped on the side of a dusty road in Basra. I think about my friend all the time, and the price he was willing to pay to be a journalist, to protect me. And I want to tell him, a drop of your blood spilling is my blood spilling. Thank you.